Hello, and this is Shiv Shankar Dyal. I welcome again you to computerprogramming.org's video. And if you remember our previous part, we had this program. Now I have added four lines to this program. These four lines from here to here. And if you remember from our previous program, then the value of ampersand I and the value of this P, this guy, ampersand I and P, both were same. And therefore, if you modify star P, then I will become 7. And if you modify I to 9, then star P will become 9. This is because the handles, that is P and I, are both pointing to same location. Let's see this in effect. I actually done previous one. So see, you get the same memory address, and therefore if we modify star P to 7, then I become 7, and if we modify I to be 9, then star P becomes 9. Now this is all fine, this is all stack manipulation, but the real uses of pointer is to allocate memory on heap. To allocate memory on heap, what you need to do is you need to read up on four functions. So these are man pages from Linux Programmer's Manual, and the functions are malloc, free, calloc, and realloc. Malloc, calloc, and realloc, all three returns a pointer to the area of memory allocated, and free frees that area, but it takes void pointer. Malloc takes size of the memory you need, how much memory you want to allocate. Calloc takes number of members and size of each member. And calloc also clears the memory area, that is, it sets them. While realloc will take the original pointer and the new size. So if you have allocated, let's say, an int pointer pointing to four integers, and you want to resize it to maybe eight or maybe three, then you should give the new size. You can read up more over here for these man pages. It will give you a very clear picture what it does. Now the crux here is, what is this size underscore t? Now clearly malloc is a function which allocates memory, and how much memory it will allocate is dependent on size we pass, and size is bound by its variable type size underscore t. So what is size underscore t? On 32-bit systems, size underscore t should be large enough to point up to 4 gigs, and on a 64-bit system, it should be large enough to point to 16 exabytes. Therefore, if you refer to one particular file which I have, POSIX types, so here it clearly says, most 32-bit architectures use unsigned int, size underscore t, and all 64-bit architectures use unsigned long, size underscore t. What this essentially means is, on 32-bit system, it's a type def to unsigned int, and on 64-bit systems, it is type def to unsigned long, where long will be 8 bytes. Now, unsigned long 8 byte means you can have values ranging from 0 to 2 to the power 64 minus 1. Not minus 1 to the power, but to the value 2 to the power 64. This means that you can address up to 2 to the power 64 bytes of memory in 64 bit with your unsigned long, and size underscore t is for both. So you see, now this is a 32-bit machine, so it is unsigned int. So that is the key point I wanted to talk about in this. Now, since size underscore t is guaranteed to be this, but ints are not guaranteed. Int may be 2 byte, int may be 4 byte. So you can say size underscore t can be used as a portable unsigned int or an unsigned integral value. Similarly, if you want a small one, then you can use a char or maybe short. But for 1 byte integers, you are better off using signed characters or unsigned characters as integral values. For 2 byte, you should prefer short ints. And for 4 bytes, you should prefer size underscore t on 32-bit architectures or even plain int. For that matter, you have fixed width integers also, int 32 underscore t, if I remember. So let me check this. So if you look in this header, stdint.h, you should have that. Okay. So if you want to ensure that how much should be my width of type, then you should use these names. These are guaranteed as per their name. So int 32 underscore t is guaranteed to be 32 bits on every platform, and int 64 underscore t is guaranteed to be 64 underscore t on all platforms. So rather than using plain int, it is much better to write int 32 underscore t or int 16 underscore t as desired. And you can then apply the modifier signed or unsigned in front of them as you wish. So that's it for this tutorial. I will meet you in our next part when I'll show you some memory allocation and some freeing of the allocated memory. Till then, happy programming. Thanks for watching the video.